Interfaith Refugee Day in conjunction with the International Harmony Week. And first I would like to thank to the organizers by organizing this considered educational program to educate the people, educate the human being to live peacefully and happily in the society. Just now, earlier, our brothers and sisters, they already explained how understanding of the global refugees crisis. And when the refugees have a solution for the crisis, they are in the situation, and they have explained about solution with the various speakers. And in addition to that, today we have tried to focus about interfaith. How religions can help or assist to bring peace and harmony or process peace to the world. When we think about the world, there are millions of people suffering daily with the pain, anger, loss, and not in the just in the poor, war-torn countries. Even rich and peaceful society. Definitely, each and every one of us suffering from various problems. Family members, they cannot get alone among themselves. Even loss of trust in the society and more tension and anger and child abuse cases are getting more often. So therefore, we need the peace in much today's society. And when we think about suffering is not only for one race, one religion, or whether you are poor or rich, whether you are uneducated or highly educated, but suffering comes from for each and every one of us. Not only human beings, even animals. Whether like so-called fish in the water, now today we put all the chemicals or plastic and other things. After eating, the fish also will die. Even the other animals also. We create ourselves the suffering for the even animals and other living beings. So, being ourselves, human beings, our thought and compassion go out to all those who are suffers, women and even children, refugee groups, and who are still waiting for help and compassion, praying for mercy or just an opportunity to restart and rebuild their life for today. No different from other periods, especially in darker part of our human society, human history. Even though today our society has developed with the modern technology, but still people are suffering. So therefore, we need to focus on common value, respect, loving kindness, for balance for the society, regardless of religion or religious belief or culture background. This will contribute to their peacemaking process, starting from our own self and the larger society and to the world. Now we come to our topic, how religions can help to process the peace. Today we are very happy. We are living in the multiracial, multireligious country. We are going to hear from different prayers how we can work together with understanding for peace. We are not only focusing for only one group or one country, one nation, for generally for everybody. When we talk about our great master Buddha, even his fundamental Buddhism has focused on suffering. Buddha has taught us Four Noble Truths, suffering and how to put an end to end of suffering. Being are the fundamental teaching of the Buddha. All Buddhists, we follow the fundamental teaching of the Buddha, especially has explained and taught an ordinary human being, even for everybody, the common principle, basic principle, we call five questions. It's very simple if we can practice. So he has introduced to the people to practice five questions. So what are these? We call not to kill, not causing harm to others, not to make people fear, or take away life of others. In return, what we have to do is cultivate loving kindness, care and compassion for the other people. Then second precept, he taught us not to steal. Respect for self and others, property, build trust, honesty and integrity, not take anything which was not given to us, not stealing from society, nature, for future generation, well-being of others. How wonderful if we can consider not stealing away peace and prosperity of children. May they have the protection and support to grow up peaceful wherever they may be now. Third precept, he has explained, no sexual misconduct, focusing on social harmony, respect for women, children, and to manage the natural desire, which often lead to ego and hatred. At the minimum effect of peace in within ourselves. Then not to tell lies or no wrong speech, self-respect and self-control, build trust and confidence in the society. At the workplace or reflecting right conduct on one. Fifth precept or last precept, no intoxication or liquor. Thank you. No taking or drugs or alcohol to ensure clarity of our mind and thought, and not to engage other misconduct activities just now as I highlighted earlier. So these five precepts he introduced to everybody to practice. When we analyze the five precepts, each and every one of our life, we can control, if we can understand, and we will be able to practice, we can build up healthy society. Then again, the Buddha, he has introduced us to practice. Another theme in dana is called charity. Anything that fitting to one in need of help, food, shelter, medicine, protection, education, confidence and happiness, and courage, right mindset and right thinking. This way we will be able to practice charity. Then again, we must practice sila, discipline ourselves. right conduct, which is built on universal value of love, compassion, which will be for greed, cause greed and hatred, control of conduct in bodily action, as well as speech and thought for causing no harm and suffering to others, now or hereafter. The third one is bhavana, meditation. The practice of meditation and to let go of worldly desire, anger, pain and suffering, and to attain wisdom. These three principles he has introduced to people to practice. Practice charity. At the same time, we discipline ourselves and cultivate ourselves. What else can we do? Is there a limit to love and compassion? No. Is there a limit to how much we should care and donate to charitable activities? No. One should always find opportunity to offer help, to care and to give courage to those who suffer, to help them to recover, rise again and be free from all pain and suffering. This is the good common belief and useful universal value. Change can be happen. Peace is possible and freedom from suffering can be reality to all of us. We should not be ignorant. We all can fall into the depth of suffering in blink of our own eyes. If we are careless and fell into our own bad conduct or speech or thought, part of our suffering are direct result from our own doing. Now how are we going to make it ourselves to get the blessing to all with love and compassion? Starting from our own heart and mind, practice generosity, get better with giving and offering in every opportunity time. What do we give? Yes, we can give, offer forgiveness, let go anger, let go painful past feeling, let go for fear and hatred, asking for justice, get even, continue to go back to the cycle of hatred and pain. Peace and harmony need to build on confidence and trust, love and compassion, which is common teaching of all the religion. Now, brothers and sisters, we are here to get ideas, get opinion, share our knowledge with all our brothers. But when we think about the human society, most of us, at least, we follow one faith. Whether you are Islam or Buddhist or Christian or Hindu, majority of us, we follow at least one faith. But unfortunately, most of us, we are only labeled followers. If we can learn our great master's teaching, Islam or Christian or Buddhist or Hindu or other faith, after learning with understanding, if we can practice, definitely we will be able to build peace and harmony to the society, to the nation, to the world. So therefore, we always must try our best to encourage people to learn their respective religion, religious teaching, and at the same time with understanding and practice. So when we practice, definitely and automatically we will be able to build up healthy society to the world. So once again, thank you being with us this morning, and hopefully we'll be able to build healthy society to the world and reduce all this negative thought, negative activities, and to help and support and eradicate all the refugees in the world will be a healthy world, and wish each and every one of you find peace and happiness. Thank you.